गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन द अर्लियर क्लासेस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन डिटेल द क्वांटिटी एस्पेक्ट एंड द क्वालिटी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ अवर ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज. टुडे वी शैल बी डिस्कसिंग द स्पेस एंड टाइम. आई एम डूइंग दीज थिंग इन वेरी इलेबोरेशन, सो लिसन दीज थिंग्स वेरी केयरफुली एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. नाउ द थर्ड पॉइंट इज ह्यूमन रिसोर्स प्लानिंग इंक्लूड्स the third factor as a space. Space means where do we need the employee. You see, by space we mean the hierarchy within the organization, and space also means, for example, it is a geographically dispersed organization. Let's say it is having its head office in Delhi and in eight and ten other places throughout the length and breadth of our country where it is having its branches. Now, space here means where do we need, where there is a shortage. The shortage can be at the head office, the shortage can be of the any of the 8 to 9 branches of the company which are spread out. I'm just giving an example. So, not only the quantity, not only the quality, but space is also very important. By space means where do we need to place the persons, where there is a requirement. And we need to find out the right kind of requirement where we need to place the employees. So it is very important, if there is a void, if there is a requirement, then it should be fulfilled adequately at the right time without delaying anything. So quantity of human resources is important, quality is important, and space, wherever they are required in the organization, by space we mean it means the physical also, it means the hierarchical also, those manpower should be procured and placed appropriately. Right? So where there is a need, a space is created. That's it. In any pair, anywhere throughout the length and breadth of the organization, it may be another branch, it may be within the branch, anywhere concerning that particular organization. Now the fourth is time. When do we need the employees? How long we need them? Now, the first question says, when do we need the employees? Let's say we have some production. It's a production-based organization. And we have scheduled the production for the next, there is a projection for the next 6 months to, next 6 months to 1 year. Now, we should know adequately that after 6 months, by through appropriate HRP forecasting, that is human resource planning forecasting, that how many people will be needed after 6 months, since we are changing the production schedule. Similarly, down the line, 1 year henceforth, we need to plan something. We have to assess the market. We have to assess accordingly the production schedule plus the quantity of production and the economic trend also and the market viability of our product, so that we are able to procure the right kind of people during the forthcoming time period. So let's say after 1 month, let's say after 6 months, or let's say after 1 year, we have a projection based on forecasting, and accordingly, the timing is very important. At the appropriate time, the required number of people should be available for the organization. So very important. Now the second question says, how long do we need? Now here I think, student, you might have got some indication how long we need. It means it is talking not only of the permanent employees but also the temporary employees. Why? Because let's say there is an organization, there are 1,000 people working there, 200 people, they are temporary. Why temporary people are kept? Because whenever there is no need of them, they may be retrenched suitably or laid off suitably. So, how long we need men? Let's say for the next 6 months, there is a production schedule and there is a peak time and we need more number of people. So, for this 6 months duration, we will be needing them. And maybe after 6 months, there is a downslide and we have to reduce our production or quantity of output. So, naturally, adequately, we will lay off the people. ले ऑफ मीन्स यानी कि उनको जो टेम्परेरी वर्कर्स है उनको निकाल दिया जाएगा, जिससे कि एडुकेट मैन पावर को मेंटेन किया है. You have to understand one thing, students. Neither this I have told you earlier also. Manpower planning is a very crucial thing for the organization, because if it is ineffective, the whole organization is going to suffer. So timing is very important. Appropriate timing, whenever they are required, they should be made available. So I have discussed all these four basic aspects of, you can say, human resource planning in terms of quantity, in terms of quality, in terms of space and time. Remember these in all these lectures, in these three lectures. Try to understand the basic. It is very, because if you understand the human resource planning's basic, as a HR person, you will find yourself, you will be more prone to understanding more concepts in times to come. Not only for this subject, as a HR student, for future projections also, you will be able to appreciate and come to know the inner nuances of the human resource planning. These are the four ingredients which are applicable universally. So I will end here and I will continue in the next video.